In this quick tutorial, I'm going to show you how to connect your Spring Boot application to a database. And I'll start from Spring Initializer, from where you can download your customized Spring Boot framework. So let's dive into this. First of all, I'm opening my HDSQL. I have already installed MySQL locally. Now I'm connecting to my local MySQL with my username and password. So after logging in into my MySQL database with HDSQL, here I am creating a new database. I have to create a new database for the first time. Model creation and other stuff I'll be doing with JPA. Okay, so let's say we want to create an application, web application, which will be providing the history of music, just for an example. So in that case, I am setting the name of the database as music history, music underscore history. So my database creation is done and my task for now in HDSQL is also done. Now I'll go to Spring Initializer. The URL is start.spring.io. Here I will be downloading my customized framework with my dependency for my music history application. So first I am making this a Gradle project. My language is Java. The version of Spring Boot is stable 2.7.4 and packaging is jar. The version of Java is 11. Now, since we are trying to develop an application which serves the history of music, the group name is com.music and the artifact is history and the description, let's say history of music. Okay, here the package name is com.music.history, which is prepared by default. I'm not changing this. And now the important part, we have to select our dependencies. So for the first dependency I'm going to add is Spring Web. This library comes with the feature of web application like REST service, frontend, and also an embedded Apache Tomcat server. So I'm selecting Spring Web. Then I have to select the MySQL driver since I'm trying to connect to MySQL database. So I'm selecting MySQL driver, and another dependency we'll be adding is JPA. JPA has a lots of feature in terms of database. So let's add spring.jpa. This is the three dependency I'm adding initially to download my customized framework for music history application. So I'm clicking on generate and saving the zip file to my desired folder. After downloading the zip file, I am extracting it and then I'm opening the folder, opening the extracted folder with an IDE, let's say Eclipse or IntelliJ. So here I have opened my IntelliJ. The name of the folder is history. So I'm clicking on the folder and then clicking on OK. Since I'll be making changes and run this project, I'm clicking on trust this project for IntelliJ to enable editing and all other features. Here, now for the first time, it will take some time to download all the dependencies I have selected and also to index the JDK. So for the first time, it may take few minutes based on your PC and your connection. So let's wait for a while. Now our dependency syncing is complete. Here, my project will start from this history application and my IDE IntelliJ has auto configured it already. Here if I click on this run, the Spring application will start. So I just clicked on run to see what happens. It's saying that it's failed to do some auto configuration related to database. Since we have selected MySQL driver but we didn't configure anything, that's why our application is not starting. So let's configure the database and then run again. To configure database, I have to go to the folder name resources, which is under source.main.resources under main folder. Here under resources folder, we have few folder and file. We have to open the application.properties file. This will be having all the application configuration and properties file. So here we have to configure our database with database URL, main IP domain, IP or domain with port, and our database username and password. So for that, I'm typing spring.datasource.url. Here the URL is jdbc:mysql:// Since my database is hosted locally, I'll be setting localhost. If your database is in different domain or in different IP address, you will be configuring it here. My database is hosted on localhost on default MySQL port, which is 3306, and then the name of my database, which I have just created with the name. Okay, this is the URL of database. Then we have to add the username, which is spring.datasource.username. In my case, I have set the username as Zaman, Z-A-M-A-N. And then we have to set the password for our database, which is in my case also Zaman for this tutorial. So as you can see in application.properties file, the syntax is in left side will be set the key, then equal sign, and then the value. And we do not have any semicolon or comma. So this is the very basic configuration you need to connect your application to the database. Previously we are facing some error. Now let's run it again and see what happens. Yes, our application is now running on port 8089 without any error. So we can say that our application is actually connected to the database. Now in the following tutorial, I'll be showing you how you can create your tables and set mapping and everything from your Spring application with entity annotation, which is basically database model. And I'll also show you how you can use JPA to generate database schema and many more. If you are actually helped with this tutorial and learned something out of it, I would request you to click on the like button. And also, if you want more similar content, you can subscribe to my channel. That will actually encourage me to make more helpful content. Thank you so much once again for watching.